essentially a crisis of the advanced capitalist world, where everything had become financialized to such an extent, and people had a certain standard of living. And when that standard of living was affected, the crisis was seen to be huge. In Brazil, you have a very rich layer that rules the country and is very dominant and doesn't pay any taxes. But for the rest of the country, and if they had money invested in some of these big banks, that was another thing. But for most ordinary people in Brazil, it didn't make too much difference. But that doesn't mean it won't get worse here. One shouldn't be complacent. But this was essentially a crisis of the financial markets and financialization. And Brazil, for good reasons, did not owe any money to these people. The debt had been paid off, they couldn't renege on the debt, etc., etc. So it survived this particular crisis. But that doesn't mean it will be immune if there is a new round. And the same applies to China, the same applies to Russia.